What did I say to piss you off this time? Baby!
Who is the Negro in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, I say, who is the Negro in your neighborhood when you're running from his ass each day?
Black people don't hope, we wish.
Something that crazy could only come from you.
Right now you live in belief. You want to believe things. Belief is ignorance. Right knowledge is to know. You understand that? Belief is ignorance because belief is the acceptance of things that you do not know. And every one of your prayers end with Amen.
Let me hear you say amen. Oh, let me hear you say amen.
Amen, which is the ancient Egyptian god, Amun, and the rock was the sun in us as original people of the sun. And we roamed the earth millions of years, 17 million, 250,000 years exact, before Adam was created 49,000 years ago. Now, we don't know good people from bad. We don't know good food from bad. We don't know good music from bad. We don't know anything, and we were the ones who knew everything. And so they put us under a spell. What kind of spell? The spell of ghost worship. You understand? Ghost worship. And they said gospel. Ghost spell. All you know is what they told you, and you have belief in what they told you. When we were in our right state, state of Elohim, we didn't have beliefs. We knew, because we were the gods that everybody worshiped. They made us hate the rising of the sun by telling us, make sure you don't make fudge while the sun is rising. That's because we were sun people. People trying to get away from the sun made us start hating the sun. How'd they make you hate your hair? No, by telling you to pick cotton. The moment we stop comping our hair and cussing our hair and putting our feet on the grass again, things are going to start opening. We lost our eye and our life is dead.
Oh, yes, baby. You know who it is coming through, coming through, coming through once again. That's right. From New York, Jamaica, to Cali, Japan, Domo Domo, live from Ground Zero. It's the fastest 30 minutes on air. Your radio show, Bust That Ass, 83.17 FMX. And of course, you know, the X stands for you never saw me coming when you never saw I was at. Dumbass, your black Lenny Bruce on the loose, who's better than that balding mini-me, two-pump and chump of a boyfriend. And yes, I want rings around that flat ass like Saturn, so test me, bitch. And if I say anything to offend you, then you know I'm doing my motherfucking job, because you have the option of turning me off, but I keep turning you on again and again and again, like rubbing your hands through her hair, only to find some swollen ticks living in the weave. Cash ass, let's ride, bitches. You know how we jump into this shit. That's right. With LA Racist Entitlement and Request, the first question of the day goes like a this. Okay, so does the crime index in such a crime incompetent state of penal industrialization make exceptions for blatant stupidity that any five-year-old from Nigeria would laugh at when their predecessors are Pavlovic to task in a group setting? Or is it easy to catch a pool of dumb fish with one net than to chase a single smart fish with many nets? You be the judge. And LA Ground Zero is bereft of individuals who delusion themselves as quote-unquote king of their jungles, when in actuality, the throne is mutable between the lounge chair and being stranded on a toilet bowl. But when it comes to gangs and the mentality to make concise criminal moves, lacking is the zombie with no head. Take note, you dumb bastards, out of La Familia, Black Guerrilla Family, Bloods, Crips, the GOP, Republican City Council, McDonald's, KFC, Jewish Defense League, and KPFK. Let me stop there. Already lost one prodigy to racist liberal mob already. Check it. Strange are the fleas from the bitches we lay with. When it comes to organized shit and mass confusion, Hollywood makes more money propping up the stupidity of criminal invention than the racist entitlement that's never ascertained by the consuming public. As of propping up the stupidity of criminal invention of that shit, okay, as of late, groups of people are being hauled in for not having group sex. Not at all. What they're fucking badly, you know, what they are fucking badly is like, you know, it looks like a sloppy hand job from an amputee octopus. They're trying to make a career out of it. I mean, yesterday, seven hood rat bitches got served for trying to beat child services out of $500,000. Today, 13 idiots went further. Let's do the magic numbers, shall we? Orange County prosecutor says four people have been convicted of crimes relating to $154 million in medical fraud schemes in which hunderreds of healthy patients underwent unnecessary surgeries to fraudulently bill insurance companies. That shit was happening down in Skid Row months ago. Okay, more than 250 healthy patients underwent dangerous surgeries, that fraudulently billed insurance companies. The four among 19 defendants charged in the case, which has been divided into several trials because of its size. And this is funny because you're shutting down court systems all over the freaking, there's 10 court systems that are gonna be like, you know, done. There's gonna be long lines on this shit, okay? A total of 13 have been indicted by a grand jury, and 6 others pleaded guilty prior to indictment. Okay, you know where I'm going with this. What the fuck? Okay? Does a 5-star clusterfuck ring a bell here? Okay, yes, there is safety in numbers, but do those numbers act as one when greed is the primary indicator? Hell the fuck no. The system of a puppet and mastermind is very simple to the Illuminati, and what kills me is you got a bunch of ignorant sad sacks of shit out here trying to mimic it in detail. What's even funnier is the hierarchy, okay? How in the fuck does a Gavacho become the head of the Mexican Mafia, a snitch, a leader of the BGF, and a sellout nigga chairman of the city council? Is the word Patsy floating in front of you? Obviously, if I had a billboard, motherfuckers still would need cheat sheets to read it. In the mob life, which is, which so many have ruined their Machiavellian entitlement on renaming it with style without substance, i.e. thug life, can't pull off Ocean's 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 3/4 when there's no unity Mensa at all. The best teams to get away with criminal activity is always the ones with the multicultural center. You need proof? Look at the gangs in the streets now. I mean, no inclusion at all. I can't be a black in a Korean gang out here unless the bitch chose me over a father's prearranged marriage. Then Coco Jin is in, you know? Here's something progressive. Incorporate, oh my God, a total business venture that would take the stigma off your dumb ass, and it would give those who do white and black collar crime a precedent in using cultural identity for more than a badge of false pride and something that doesn't pride itself in cause? This way, you're not dependent on whitey's money, and as they would say, you know, community buildup can shield it from economic segregation. And that means, which is largely imposed by those who still want to be impoverished, to keep paying for the lifestyles of the affluent. I mean, the poor pay for the rich. This shit's been going on for the last 400 years. What do you think slavery was? Okay? Don't mind me. Just keep cleaning Miss Beverly Hills' house, and you might catch up. I mean, come on, man. The silver is in the upper draw, bitch. Get it? Think about it. I'll be black after this. Shit, Nelly, baby, you know where we at. Mosquito's Facebook report, fat bitch, you didn't dick. Ha ha. Oh, the stuff I found on my Facebook, amazing, shocking, but true. But then again, you know, where else am I going to get it from? Okay. This is from Assbuster, thegrio.com. I saw the lady who runs this shit. She was on MSNBC. Nice looking sister and so forth. But it's a pic post of how Hollywood still takes stock in ridicule of the black man, even if he's not in black. It shows Sasha Gatwa, 26, head of the new media desk for the Israeli Defense Force, IDF, going Obama-style blackface on, of all places, Facebook. You dumb motherfucker. If I was white-faced, I'd be in the Ku Klux Klan. Okay? All right, and this sent in from Assbuster Shaquem, Shaquem Sulu, King Shabazz. Big post of rednecks on what looks like a home built jalopy. They rolling four deep. It says niggas be like Lamborghini Mercy. Wait for it. Bam. Okay. And finally, I do have this from Assbuster Equality. Shakiba, let's see, ESQ, my boy, he's got a new album out, okay, I suggest you guys get it, he's got some nice cuts on it and shit, but the funny thing is that he called it Black Friday, okay, so this runs in fact with Black Friday, White Saturday, Regretful Sunday, Mournful Monday, Tuesday, Giving Tuesday, and what the hell Wednesday. Okay, they call it Stormy Monday for a simple reason, okay? Because Tuesday is just as bad, Wednesday is worse, and by Thursday I'm feeling sad. Friday, the eagle flies on Friday, but Saturday I go out to play. By Sunday, my good people, motherfuckers in church are trying to pray. Yes, yeah, I know, my cat is fat, that's why I call her a cow. Black Aborka, how many America is, how am I, my oh my, how America is sitting a bit antsy, especially when Lord Obama is looking downhill at your ass after you got thrown under the bus for no reason other than race related. As we troll into next year, Big Broham gotta let some of us out, you know, the militant niggas. You know, who got railroaded by corrupt and racist law enforcement. Check it. With a lame duck Congress and that pardons more turkeys than it does its political and social prisoners, the Fab Four, who have been railroaded by this country, the FBI, and the racist judicial system, Ramiro Munoz, Leonard Peltier, Assata Shakur, and Mumia Abu-Jamal, all people of color and social activism, are either serving life sentences, sitting on death row, or have fled this bullshit country to go to fucking Cuba or Africa. Hey, if you're black enough, you can fit right in, and when the natives know who you are, they'll hide that ass quick. Which brings to light that when you speak up about incorporated injustice, why is thought and ideology the scarlet letter to having your ass killed over censorship? Strong, clear beliefs to the contrary of what goes on in the dead of night is against the law. What the fuck? Why do you think Geronimo Pratt has yet to speak out and is enjoying his retirement? It wasn't from a presidential pardon, it was like Nelson Mandela, time served. Okay, when commuting sentences, America has 217 political prisoners, Guantanamo Bay is still in operation, yo. Okay, so look, I mean, come on, the Navy still has Cold War districting in the fucking area, ask them, dumbass. All 217 of these prisoners are mostly people of color, so now that we have a two-term half-row president, you think Lord Obama will be on this? By February of next year, one of these four has to come out. If not, then I suggest Amnesty International and the Innocent Project to stop fucking around and take a bolder direction for the national spotlight and prove that not only censorship is dangerous in the wrong hands, it will cost you your freedom when they need that voice of dissension to die in their shadows. Okay? You got to think about that one, people, because, you know, that's how that shit works. And then afterwards, they could say that the Charles Manson litmus was indeed a success. That motherfucker ain't never coming out. But he did record some crazy shit, so buy the album before the FBI crash it. In response, free Leonard Peltier, free Mumia Abu-Jamal, allow Assata Shakur to return to the United States so she can visit the grave of her nephew, Tupac. Free Ramiro Munoz, and free the weed. Ganja no do wrong on the people's intent and greedy control, bitches. That's right, monkey nuts, motherfucker. Dirty condoms. Okay, so whatever you do, make sure there's no drama from the Village Idiot sign on your fucking front door. Had one in the studio last night. Dumbass wouldn't shut the fuck up. I mean, what the hell, man? Why are you beating over a fucking dead fucking subject that you have? The only reason why you do shit like that, D-Lo, is because, one, you need to hear yourself speak. All right, especially when there's nothing happening. You have to cause contention. Don't do that shit in my house, motherfucker. What's wrong with you? Got new neighbors in the Sunshine House. So far, they're responsible terrorists. Unlike the 47% of the electoral that Mittens wound up with after it was all said and done, a sweep through netted more porch monkeys and barrachos. Oh, yeah. Yeah, isn't that divine justice? I mean, the motherfucker called 47% and got 47% of the electoral vote. That's fucking funny. And before I forget, freebooting on the MTA will be on lockdown after the 1st of next year. They're putting the boot on the turnstiles. So leap over them if you can, but if you're too fucking fat, I suggest you start running. Or until you get caught. Just don't bring a whole bunch of niggas with you, though, because that shit can fuck up your goddamn game plan.
Relax and just sit down and just let me find my shit, okay?
How many of you out there think this country's a democracy? How many of you out there think this country's a democracy? As the spray paint on the wall so often says, if voting changed anything, they'd make it illegal.
Who is it?
Ross?
Are you by yourself?
Yeah, I'm by myself.
You sure? You sure?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm sure, I'm by myself.
When more people realize that overthrowing the rich is not just in our own best interest, it's a hell of a lot of fun.
Yeah, I'm sure, I'm by myself.
It's a hell of a lot of fun. It's a hell of a lot of fun. It's a hell of a lot of fun. As the spray paint on the wall so often says, when more people realize that overthrowing the rich is not just in our own best interest, it's a hell of a lot. People didn't vote for Star Wars. People didn't vote for drug wars. No one voted for acid rain. People didn't vote for Star Wars. People didn't vote for drug wars. No one voted for acid rain.
Ooh, yes, that message is coming in for cultural nepotism, baby. Okay, so why does it always take our ignorance to ignore what our body is always saying in sickness, but we're just too fucking dumb to find the catalyst? The reason is that as long as we're fed to be sick, fear will continue to treat us. So when I vouch on naturalism as a mode to go against the current flow of microfacility, motherfuckers will defend GMO in the soul food quicker than donate time to help the homeless who have to eat that shit. Check it. In a massive blow to multinational agribiz corporations such as Monsanto, Bayer, and Dow, Peru has officially passed a law banning genetically modified ingredients anywhere within the country for a full decade before coming up with another review. The introduction of genetically modified organisms, GMOs, will compromise the native species of Peru, such as the giant white corn, purple corn, and of course the famous species of Peruvian potatoes. Annabel Huerta, president of Peru's Agrarian Commission, said the ban was needed to prevent the danger, quote-unquote danger, that can arise from the use of biotechnology, unquote. What the fuck? Holy shit. Can any of you dumb hoes say birth defects? In a recent test conducted by the Peruvian Association of Consumers and Users, ASPEC, I love that, at the time of the ban's implementation found that 77% of the supermarket products tested contained GMO contaminants. ASPEC confirms something that Peruvians knew all along. GM foods are on the shelves of markets and wineries, and consumers buy them and take them into their homes and eat them without knowing it. No one says anything, which involves a clear violation of your right to information. With that in mind, the poor on welfare and food stamps are the most susceptible. Motherfuckers in jail never know, and when you have a nation ODing off corn syrup modifications like hordes of junkies, it's no wonder motherfuckers in business are screaming bloody murder about Obamacare, especially when they have to pay for trying to keep motherfuckers stuck on products they intentionally know are GMO modified and used by the very employees they want to get rid of. Talk about career goals justified. It's no wonder yellow corn died out at Taco Bell 15 years ago. White corn is cheaper, labor is cheaper, and everybody gets exploited while the environment goes to shit. You know what I mean? Now that's what I call progress. Freeborn means free of man-made bullshit. Your excuse, it tastes good and it's convenient. Like my dick in your mouth, bitch. And you wonder why a bitch today can't cook for shit. Fuck Monsanto, I grow my own.
The pledge to resist. We believe that as a people living in the United States, it is our responsibility to resist the injustices done by our government in our names. Not in our name will you wage endless war. There can be no more deaths, no more transfusions of blood for oil. Not in our name will you invade countries, bomb civilians, kill more children, letting history take its course over the graves of the nameless. Not in our names will you erode the very freedoms you have claimed to fight for. Not by our hands will we supply weapons and funding for the annihilation of families on foreign soil. Not by our mouths will we let fear silence us. Not by our hearts will we allow whole peoples or countries to be deemed evil. Not by our will and not in our name.
Ah, yes, my people. And now we've come to that favorite part of the show where we have to take our thumbs and split that vertical mouthpiece in half and look at the brown eye, because it is a person, place, or thing that gets up on your nerve, my last nerve, and above all, seeks to de-educate you from what you are supposed to be as a human being. So therefore, we call upon the spirit of the 1, 2, 3 in the mighty Wusa. All together now, on one, on a 2, and a 3, and a mighty Wusa, as whole of the day. There are some that eclipse the very nature of existence, only to find the best way to stop ass splash from the toilet is to have your face so close to the toilet water. Dumbass. When it's done from the stages of the greatest crooks known to human stupidity, sheeple will follow the dreams of fools in order to put heaven on layaway. Check it. Meet Robert H. Schuller, the founder of Crystal Cathedral and the face of a globally watched Hour of Power television program. And his family will be paid just a fraction of the millions they sought from the preacher's bankrupt ministry. For decades, these crackers made loot on the premise of religion. But wait, there's more sardines and pork and bean, bitches. The ruling cuts short a 10-day trial focused on unpaid contracts and copyright infringement claims filed by Schuller, his wife Arabella, his daughter, and his son-in-law. Judge Robert N. Qua wrote that Schuller will receive about $600,000 because he failed to prove that intellectual property and copyright violations took place. Less than $100,000 will be divided by other family members. The ministry, once known for its showy services and uplifting sermons, filed for bankruptcy protection in 2010, citing $50 million in debt. What the fuck? I'm just thinking how many dumb religious right and conservative proselytizers who sit at home all fucking day watching bullshit on Channel Zero, okay? God is not in a box. Jah is everywhere. And what belief does a motherfucker have when you're giving time and money into an institution that from the days of the Inquisition and the plunder of indigenous cultures has never been that fucking broke? Look under the Vatican, you fucking scaly ape. The loot from the Pope 1 to Pope 147 has an estimated value that rivals the diamond cash in Mother Russia. Duh, has anyone heard of Russia being broke like the rest of the European Union? Like Billy Graham, Reverend Ike, Jim and Tammy Faye Baker, Creflo Dollar, T.D. Jakes, and the rest of their Steve Harvey bullshit patrol, motherfucking Rob Schuller was a successful husker, and like all entertainers, all your monies are recoupable under the laws of popularity, economics, and if your dick gets hard while watching Ron Jeremy's porn production of the Power Pope and Pussy Series Volume 1. If there's an infringement, there's one against the people who are blind to understanding what they should be able to make a decision on, even as a community. If you can't understand what you see and read in the Bible, then you deserve to be faithful to poverty. Because there's not one stupid son of a bitch, and that's boss spelled backwards, out there that can't say Rob Schuller ran his operation in the same vein as the Church of Scientology. Them motherfuckers take everything and build nothing more than global scandal, leaving many beyond the capable shape of living with spiritual dignity. Damn, ain't the devil happy? Yep, Robert Schuller, Reverend Robert Schuller of the late Cathedral City Church Ministries.
Someone cuts in front of me, and though I've known, never shown she's gone, doing what she wants to do, giving away my trust for free. I didn't whore you out like you wanted, your man gave you clearance, ain't you funny? When the other guys to blind, you have to stand by. I heard it all before, the same little war. No one ever burned for you, betrayed his play, and played me the dummy, still sacrificing through and through. But you don't care where you jump and damage hurting me is all you do. So real, I feel your mass emotions on the brink of deception. I ain't judging, God knows I'm alone as the SOS floats away from my home. When your clothes come off or it's strange that you met last week. I know you for years, sweetie, and yet you go back to the street. Try to pull you forward, but you go back into defeat. Who's rubbing butter squeaky when I'm not asleep? Now, I take it my time, I swore by this vow that I won't cover anything so righteously foul. Apologies and all, don't swear to be, this ain't no humanity. It's self-serving matter, sloth and mess, and stress in your best. So thank you once again, my friend. Stemming from your soul is deeper than the hate that you're holding. When you're laying on a lion to lie on a reaper that stole before the summer got cold.
Oh shit, you know where we at, that's right baby, that's right. If you missed it, then play it again till you get it. You can say moving forward like a bitch, but you know I'm ahead of your bullshit. This has been your radio show shows, Hey, bust that ass radio, 83.17 FM, and the extent for you didn't see me coming when you never saw what I've been all up in your ass. Steady shellac in the room, pum pum harder than ever, booty bubbles and dirty condoms. Music provided by Omega 7 Records, the Mothership Connection, and the Underground Music Scene. Check us out at mush777.wix.com/bustthatass, or bust that space ass radio, and leave a sneaky because it's all about cash ass. So see you in the street, bitches. Let's get on with the rest of the week. Hey, it's a real killer.
but you can't play a brother who sees the real you. Out of focus, stealing books, I'm hopeless. Focus is just destructive, yeah. I should have done you then when my name was nothing but a martyr, but you murdered my essentiated character.